thing. Girl, I don't know why I can't get enough of your love, thing. Lord, some things I can't get used to, no matter how I try. It's like the more you give.
Hey, Jordo, Chucky here, just in my pajamas, 8 o'clock. You're probably already in bed, but I just wanted to thank you for being such a great mentor to me for all my life. I looked up to you. You're a little older than I am, but you just have a way and a style that I think is a way for all of us. You know, you have that way of holding yourself back, holding your tongue, not saying things that you shouldn't say, that you know, never make a smart-ass comment from the back of the room. And by all means, you know, always be kind to those people around you. So, George, thanks for that. But I want to particularly thank you for what you've taught me in tennis. Like, I want to, like, the forehand, this brush here, this is my brush. Just pretend for a second that this is a tennis racket. When you approach the ball to hit a forehand, for example, instead of hitting low to high and finish through, what you do is you charge the ball. That you go slowly because your knees are pretty arthritic, and you just hold that racket on an angle and you just cut the shit out of it like this so it falls like a wet turd on the other side of the net. So I learned that from you, George. On the backhand, it's not low to high with a two-handed backhand. It's approach the ball once again, stop quickly, hit it with a violent cut so it falls like a soft-boiled egg on the other side of the net and just splats, and the other guy has no friggin' chance whatsoever. So there you go, George. You've been my hero forever, and you've been it's just important for my life and for my future and for my success. I love you, buddy. Happy birthday.
Hi, George. It's Bill calling from Naramata to wish you a happy 80th birthday. You may not recall this, but I've known you for almost 60 years. We first met at the fraternity house where you were the summer manager, and remember you had that red Volvo, and I rented it from you for a party. Can't remember what the party was for, but anyway, that's when I first met you. And thinking about some of the good times we've had together, and one of the more memorable ones was that trip we took to the Maritimes that Bruce organized, that golf trip. And I was talking to Carolyn about the number of laughs we had on that trip. It was really a lot of fun. I remember a picture of you dancing with Sherry's mother at that lobster dinner that she threw for us, and it was absolutely priceless. I hope that you still have that. It's just a very memorable shot. Anyway, my time is coming to an end, and I hope to see you in the desert this fall. We always have fun with you. We'll have a dinner and catch up. But happy birthday, and looking forward to seeing you and Stewie again. Bye-bye.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy 80th birthday, dear George.
You old coot.
Happy birthday to you.
Wishing you all the best and a fun celebration from Allison and Bob. You're the best. Bye.
Hey, George, you can see we get all dressed up just for you. Well, not just for you. We've got another 80th birthday party tonight that we're going to go to. So we thought we'd multitask and just shout out this little video to you on your birthday. Have a great day. You're one of the most entertaining guys I know. Happy to be your buddy.
Happy birthday, George. Love seeing you and Stewie, whether it's at the club or down in the Bahamas.
Anywhere. Love
Anywhere.
To see you.
Love it.
Bye.
Happy birthday.
Georgie, Georgie, puddin' and pie, hits the ball as far as the sky. Where it lands, he sometimes sees, as he brings the Hatfield down to its knees. A charming rogue, he'll lead you down a road,
Life with him is ever a lark, and he's never lacking on a gorgeous remark.
Hey, George.
Hey, George.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Cheers.
Big 8-0.
Cheers. Wish you were here to have some very fine wine with us. We'll have to make sure that we catch you after your big day. We're up north here in Collingwood and enjoying it very much. This has to be a stop for you one of these days, because we love to have you, and it's a really sweet place to relax and have fun and laugh together, which is what I think of you all the time.
Every time we're together, George, we end up with sore cheeks, which is a really good sign. So we really enjoy being around you, and we really hope your birthday is a good one, and you'll have a few more decades to celebrate together.
Yeah, for sure. You have a gift, and your gift is to just make everyone laugh, and we're right up there. Just love giggling with you. You're so witty and smart, and did I mention bright? Like, what else? Okay, I better stop, or your head is already
spinning too much,
and we don't want it to fly away. So
anyway, one last cheers.
Yeah,
to
cheers.
You.
Happy 80th birthday, big guy. You look not a day older than 60, and we only hope that when we reach that age, we look and feel as good as you are, and that you're around to celebrate it with us.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye.
And I've just followed the instructions. I've digitated the camera into a kaboobalization motion. And I think the digitation and the affonserators are effectively working.
Well, thank goodness.
So, George is having is this his 60th?
No. He's already celebrated that. You know, he had a big celebration at Hockley Valley.
Oh, Hockley Valley.
That was a great one.
That's when George was quite a singer.
Singer? He was a real zinger that night.
And the gorgeous chairs that we see out here still exist. George assembled them, and they stayed that way. I can't believe it.
Our favorites.
So we haven't had many of the March golf tournaments out on the ice in the Niagara Escarpment, but that's to come. And George makes a lunch.
Oh, no. He's great at breakfast. We still eat George's special microwave eggs with scrambled eggs with cheese. And every time we have them, we say, cheers to you, George. They're great. So George and Stewie have been excellent co-hosts with us.
It's not Stewie's birthday.
I know, but Stewie's got a birthday coming sometime. Anyway, we can't thank you enough, Georgie.
And the long drive, he had the long drive on the escarpment when he went through the ice. And the expectations of George were not too high, as some people said.
Amazing.
And Brian still remembers you as a single-digit handicap. He'll never change his view.
Anyway, George, we're thinking of you on this venerable birthday, 80. Congratulations and lots of love from the Wilsons.
George, congratulations, and you are the king of
the best deal in town.
The best deal in town. Happy birthday, George. Many more.
Cheers.
Hey, Giorgio. I'm so happy to be part of your memorable day. I often think of you and Stewie over the years, and especially the times we had working together at Xerox. You were always my big brother, and I was Stewie's little sister from another mother. I think it was the freckles and the blonde hair. I don't think we look much alike now. Anyways, I don't have any wild stories, but I do have one little quirk that I remember that you used to have, and it was a vroom. Every time you talked on something quite silly, it was a vroom. But when George McLaughlin and I kind of took over that, you stopped doing it. So I guess we kind of took your thunder away. Sorry about that. But I do want to say, I ran across a picture of you. It's about 48 years old, but I tell you, you haven't changed a bit. Happy birthday, George. 80 years old. What a milestone. Love you.
Hey, George, it's John and Jerry. We wanted to wish you a very, very happy 80th birthday.
Happy birthday, George.
The good news is you're now getting to the point where you can golf your age, almost. You'll just have to add another 20 years. Happy birthday.
You had a few right there, too. Yeah.
George Baldwin.
Hey, George.
Hey, George. Happy birthday, buddy. We met you and Stu shortly after you moved from Vancouver to Toronto nearly 50 years ago, the beginning of a long and very memorable, treasured friendship. You are definitely old, O-L-D friends in the true sense of the word. We couldn't count the many times we have shared dinner parties, tennis and golf games, weekends away, Larry Park days, and the list goes on. There is an old saying, they broke the mold when your parents made you, George. You are definitely—
Is that good or bad?
What with your active lifestyle, riding your bike to the BNR, playing golf and tennis, along with your sense of fun, quick wit and tongue. Most recently, your description of your recent renewal of your driver's license was hilarious.
That was great.
It was fun.
It's a good story.
Yeah, so remember that. People ask George to reiterate that. Have to say, though, the only time I ever saw you at a loss for words was when our cheeky little six-year-old son, Rob, commented on your bathing suit at the Ojibwe. You said, thanks, you like it? And he rudely fired back, no, George, your balls are hanging out. First and only time we have ever seen you speechless. That was about 37 years ago, and we have never seen it happen since. You're the best, George.
Totally does, though.
You're the best, George. Stay well. We love you.
Happy birthday,
80th,
George.
And cheers to many more.
Hey, Jim, come on in. We've got to wish George a happy birthday.
Okay, I'll be there in a minute. I've got to find my ball.
Wait, this is somebody's garden.
Yeah, I know, but it came over that fence, it hit that wall, and it's got to bounce back here. It's got to be in here. Oh, here. Oh, no. I don't play with yellow ones. No. Oh, that's no good. I don't like that one. Nope, that's not mine. Oh, what about that one? Oh my God, look what I got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Georgie. Now that's a haul that's fit for a birthday boy. Happy birthday, George.
Happy birthday, George.
Hi, George. It's John and I wishing you the best of the best birthdays. We hope you have a wonderful day. Love being your friend, and we love having you in our lives. So we wish you the best and another 80 years to follow.
Happy one. 80? Is he 80, was he really?
He is 80. Imagine being 80.
Happy birthday, George.
Have a good one.
Okay, happy birthday, George.
Happy birthday, George. A big one.
If they ever let you renew your driver's license, George, you'll have to come down to Picton and go for a little cruise on Zephyr.
Yeah.
You can help with the varnishing.
Anyway, have a great day.
Yeah.
Take care.
Ciao, big guy.
Bye.
Hey, George. Welcome to middle age. All this just reminds me of all the fun we once had. You know, roaring around in Dad's Porsche, trying to get our two Volkswagen Beetles to top 70 miles an hour by slipstreaming each other. But the one I remember most is the time that you hung a string to the lockers so Mr. Arnold would go out and try and catch somebody getting into their locker. And I spotted the the vice principal following the string up the stairs and told you to dump it out the door. And Sam Rodden couldn't figure out what was going on. That was good times. Take care, buddy.
Happy birthday, George. 80. My God, I can't believe it. You're a tall, lanky, good-looking guy who I met, I think about 40 years ago or something like that. Maybe longer. Anyway, in T.O. And I think I was maybe one of the first people that you met. Lovely that you're celebrating your 80th. And I think of you as a fun guy, a tennis guy, a wordsmith guy. And I hope you have a very, very happy day. Lots of love, Sandy.
Okay, there's a nursery rhyme that makes me think of George. Georgie, Porgie, pudding and pie, kissed the girls and made them cry. When the boys came out to play, Georgie, Porgie ran away. That's our Georgie. Happy 80th, George. Bye.
Hi, George. Happy 80th birthday, chum, and many more. I can't recall exactly when we first met, but have a hunch it might have been in North Toronto Arena, or on the tennis court at the cricket club, or through Tilly and Stewie in exercise class. That was some 40-odd years ago. Over the years, thanks to you, we have had some highly memorable times together with Hardy, Top, Toby and Rick, to name a few, on the tennis court at the BNR, golfing at Mandarin, dinners together, and socializing at friends' cocktail parties over the years. Thanks to you and Stewie, we have made a host of friends who have enhanced our lives. Finally, thank you for the one-liners that have kept us laughing well into the night. Graham, Mark, Nikki, join Tilly and me, wishing you the best of 80th celebrations. Have a great day.
Happy birthday, George. You are achieving a milestone of 80 years. Well done, and we wish you all the very, very best for the future.
Happy birthday, George, and many, many more.
Happy 80th birthday, Grampy. I'm so happy that I got to spend this special day with you. Thinking back to my memories of my childhood with you, I always remember you coming to pick me up from Armor or the Cricket Club or daycare or something like that, and you'd always point at me and look at me and be like, I know you, and then come give me a big bear hug, and it always made me feel so special and happy. I also really liked how you always would record all the episodes of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire WizKids, and also Jeopardy, and then I've actually learned like so many surprising little facts and tidbits, and I always feel so good when I got an answer right, so thank you for that too. And also all the little sneaky snacks that you would give us and the Breyers ice cream, which is surprisingly so good. So what happens at G&G's house stays at G&G's house. And also the no whining sign that you'd point to every single time I would walk into Haddington, and you'd make sure that I knew not no whining allowed. But actually that stuck with me throughout my life, surprisingly. Anyways, I love you so much and thank you for being the best grandpa ever.
Action.
Well, George, it's hard to believe that you're turning 80 considering all the rules we've learned from you about golf. First one of those that we've learned, right? Even though you didn't know necessarily could tell who we are because we had to have masks on when we first started this off, was how to play golf on the tee. First thing,
no warm up.
Second thing, bring two balls in case the first one doesn't work. That's a rule that I like to play with all the time, and certainly is one that it's been a joy getting to know you on the course and playing the same way, because honestly, you and Stewie have made the last few years through COVID, which is how we got to know you, a good part of it. So on behalf of myself, happy birthday, Sue.
Happy birthday, George. One of my favorites that I learned from you was when you're putting and it goes past the hole, listen for the sound. Beep, beep. Have a wonderful birthday, George.
On that note, happy 80th. Take care. Hope to see you on the course. So long.
Happy birthday, George.
Happy 80th birthday, George. Hope you have a great one from Haddington, Inc.
Have a good one.
Set, go.
George, we've thought long and hard on what to do for your birthday, and I've decided to write a poem. Roses are red, violets are blue. As long as I've lived, I've met no one like you. Happy birthday from Buck and Margie.
Happy birthday, George.
Hey, happy birthday, George.
Happy birthday.
Listen, we have a little limerick for you. I hope you enjoy it. Ready?
1, 2, 3. Our neighbor George might not be a saint, and quiet and demure, he sure ain't. But he's got a huge heart. We all love that old fart. George, we're so glad with you we could acquaint. Have a very happy birthday,
George. All the best to you, George. 80 more years, all right?
Bye.
Hey, Giorgio, it's Mrs. Farkle here. I'm wanting to wish you the most happy of happy 80th birthdays. So exciting. I did also want to share a little story with you that I remember from the old days. We were camping in campus or at Cultus Lake and having a wonderful time, water, fire, food, etc., etc., lots of wine. And it was shortly after dinner, and you guys had been married longer than we had. I didn't know you very well. And you and Stewie had an altercation, and back and forth, and we were all kind of minding our own business, letting you do your thing. And the next thing we know, you've dumped a whole bottle of apple juice over her long, beautiful hair. So that when I'm going, oh my God. And that was my introduction to Mr. George Baldwin, the prankster. So anyway, all's well. You have a wonderful, wonderful time. We're missing you. And I hope we can be together one day very, very soon. So happy birthday, Giorgio. We love you lots. Take care. Bye-bye.
Hey, George. Jim and Jinty here from Bracebridge, Muskoka. 80 years old. My goodness, that is just a great milestone that you've reached. We go back a long way.
How did you ever do it?
Yeah, how did you ever make it? Actually, Stewie, it's probably all your fault. You kept George just going. Anyway, we go back a long way, starting, George, with Xerox. We together had many great years there. And while we were doing that, our kids were playing hockey. We were coaching hockey. Jinty, I think you taught the dog how to swim at our cottage in Lake of Bays. On and on and on it goes. And then I think Sammy and Andrew were together at UBC. And anyway, we just wanted to check in, say hello.
And I Jinty, think it's really neat. Well, I think it's really neat that our kids are still friends and that they stay in touch. It's good connections. So wishing you happy, happy birthday. And here's to your health and happiness.
Yep, same for me. And hopefully we'll see you again soon. And great to see you a couple of weeks ago at the Hayer. So best to y'all. Goodbye.
Have a good one. Bye for now.
Landlord said this morning to me, give me your key, this lot ain't free. I can't get no rent out of you, pack up your bags and skidoo you. I've been waiting for my bill to come home, he's my honey with a honeycomb. He'll have money cause he told me so this morning, because it's moving day, moving day. Rip the carpet up off the floor, put on your overcoat and out of the door, cause it's moving day. Pack up your bags to get away. If you can't pay the rent, you gotta live it in Tempe, cause it's moving day.
Happy birthday, George. 8-0 and counting.
Good evening, George. It's Jack Way. And much as I am unaccustomed to making lengthy tributes, I'm happy to make a few comments and to wish you a happy birthday. As we all know, George is very prominent in many worlds, such as bridge, golf, tennis, and so on. And I'm just going to comment on a couple of them. The first being bridge, which is a Tuesday morning game on a regular basis. I liken it very much to Groundhog Day. There's a certain amount of repetition there. We always know that Alain is familiar with all the conventions and will advise us there too. We know that Jeff, he always has the missing cards for a finesse or for a bad trump split. Jack, on occasion, may exhibit fat fingers, with a view to enjoying the replay option. George seems to be the beneficiary of many, many powerful hands, and he is also renowned for what are now labeled George Bids violin, who's the expert. Finally, in tennis, George, you are responsible for a very large number of points on the tennis court. I'm not going to go into detail about that, but you know what they are. In any case, I wish you a very happy birthday for 80, and it's a lengthy life, and having been there for some time myself, I'm wishing you another score plus and many more years of enjoyment in their various pursuits. Happy birthday.
Hello, George. I hear it's your 80th birthday. That's fantastic, but I have to say, I was a little surprised you don't look a day over 79. Anyway, congratulations. Have a great day. I also want to say thank you for your fantastic job of organizing Bridge on Tuesdays and Thursdays with Jack Way and Alain Argerou and Paul Henderson. You've done a great job, much appreciated. Those games are always fun because your bidding is so interesting and your commentary is extraordinary, which, come to think of it, is very much like your tennis game. Anyway, have a happy birthday. Cheers.
Hey, Grampy. Happy birthday. I'm so happy to be spending the special day with you. And I've absolutely loved all the memories that we've shared together, whether that's getting a grilled cheese at the cricket when I was younger and you not letting me get another one before 20 minutes was over because my food had to digest, or observing your bald spot get bigger as I grew up. That was a key memory. I'm also enjoying making fun of you for all of the cheese whiz that you've ingested into your body. I think there's more toxins in there at this point than anything else from that. I know you still act like a 10-year-old at heart, and you're able to keep up with literally everything that we do, so I have no worries about that, although I'm sure the iron knees have helped with that as well. Anyways, I'm so grateful for you and everything that you do for us and how you keep us smiling and laughing, and I love you so much, and I'm so excited to be celebrating with you. I love you.
I've heard people say that too much of anything is not good for you, baby. But I don't know about that. There's many times that we've loved and we've shared love and made love. It doesn't seem to me like it's enough.